Good morning, everyone. This ring is one of my most prized possessions. I don't know how much it's worth, but it's of great value to me because it belonged to my mom. In fact, it belonged to my mom before it belonged to me because her mom gave it to her as when she was a teenager as a gift. And then my mom decided to do the same when I became a teenager. So I would never consider selling this ring because it's worth more to me than any amount of money that I might get if I sold it. If I were to ask you to name your most prized possession, what would it be? To some of you, it might be a stuffed animal that you've had since you were a baby. To another, it might be a favorite doll. To someone else, it might be a ball that was autographed by a famous baseball player. If a friend came to visit you in your home, would you give your most prized possession to that friend to show your love? Well, that's exactly what a woman named Mary did in our Bible story today. So one day, Jesus went to the city of Bethany. That was the city where a man named Lazarus, who Jesus raised from the dead, lived with his two sisters, Mary and Martha. While Jesus was in Bethany, a dinner was given in his honor. Lazarus was eating at the table with Jesus, while Martha was serving the meal. And Mary was just sitting at the feet of Jesus, listening to him teach. So as she was sitting at the feet of Jesus, Mary did a very unusual thing. She took a bottle of very expensive perfume and began to wash the feet of Jesus with it. Then she dried his feet with her hair. The Bible tells us that the entire house was filled with the sweet smell of perfume. One of the Jesus's disciples, whose name was Judas, you might remember him from a story that's coming up, was very upset by what Mary did. He said, "What a waste. This perfume could have been sold and the money given to the poor." It was worth a year's worth of wages. So if you don't know what wages are, that's basically an entire year's worth of being paid for doing work, okay? So that's a lot of money back then. Well, Jesus came to Mary's defense and answered Judas, "Leave her alone. She has kept this perfume for the day of my burial." Jesus said that because he knew that it was only a few days before he would be crucified and buried. I doubt if Mary knew that, but I do think that Mary wanted to give Jesus the very best that she had to show her love for him. That perfume was the very best thing that Mary had to offer. Jesus has given us the most wonderful gift imaginable, the gift of everlasting life. It's free, but it was a very costly gift. It cost Jesus his life. What can we give to Jesus to show our love for him? I don't think he wants my diamond ring, a stuffed animal, a dog, a doll, or an autographed baseball. I think he wants us to give him our very best. He wants us to give him our life. Let's pray about that. Heavenly Father, Jesus gave his life to show his love for us. May we also give our lives in service to him. As an expression of our love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
You will never stop fighting for me.